A lot at stake here as well, and one major benefit goes to the team that wins this match. They will play the fourth-placed team in the other pool. One plays four. And so, in theory, they will have some sort of advantage, the team that wins here today. There's their record, played four, won four, both unbeaten, both with the perfect records. And clearly, a lot at stake here in terms of the, I guess, gamesmanship here for the rest of the tournament, the psychological advantage of winning this match against a major opponent as well. So although there's no pressure on either of these teams in the sense that they have to win this match to be sure of progressing into the knockout stage, there is still plenty at stake for sure. So it will be a full-on, highly competitive match, and every possibility that it will go more than three sets. Both teams will be at full strength, and the Italian team, who come here with a very good record, having beaten the Dominican Republic, Japan, Great Britain and Algeria for their four wins. And there is their squad with the Paola Croce, their very experienced player, and Libero, their captain, is Eleanor Lobanchio, another one of their experienced players, 32 years of age, with 512 caps prior to the start of the Olympic Games, so she's probably playing in her 517th match, and a lot of Olympic experience as well in their captain Lobianco. Their coach Massimo Papalimo, and Papalimo looking relaxed at the moment in the final few minutes before this final pool match for his team. The opponents blue today, Russian Federation, with wins also over Great Britain, the Dominican Republic, Algeria and Japan. And there is their lineup with some real experience in their squad as well, with Evgeny Estes, and she is number four, formerly known as Evgenia Artemonova, also a very experienced player. Now in her sixth Olympic Games, she's never won a gold medal, three silvers, but still looking for that elusive gold medal. Would it come in 2012 with this Russian team, and Ekaterina Gamova, also a very experienced player on the Russian side, the opposite spiker with 231 caps, and is the top scorer in the last Olympic Games. Sergei Chinnikov, the coach of the Russian team, all is in readiness for this really intriguing match between the two teams that have emerged clearly as the best two in their pool. To the two match officials, the two senior match officials, the first and second referees, one from Serbia and the other from China today. Ah, yes, gotta look good for the big match. Zorica Balic from Serbia, the first referee, on the left, and Ning Wang, second referee from China. We'll work from the floor. These teams, you don't have to release their starting lineup until quite close to the actual start of the match. 15, 16, 17, and 18. And Paola Croce, the libero. Arighetti, Robianco, Del Core, Bossetti, and Gioli. Along with number 18, Carolina Del Pila, Costa Grande. Plenty of height and an enormous amount of experience as well. There's Ekaterina Gamova. Top scorer, as I said, at the last Olympic Games. Number 13. Evgenia Statsova. Maria Borisenko. Maria Perepalkina. Evgenia Estes, the really experienced player in the sixth Olympic Games. Krajuchkova, the libero, Kuncharova, Gamova, and 12 players on the court now ready for the start of this key match. So who will emerge as the top team in Pool A? And one of these teams will go into the knockout phase with the really important psychological advantage over their opponents, knowing that this side, who wins this match, will be unbeaten. Be Russia to serve. Evgenia Statsova. 3 meters and 6 feet eight. 31 years of age. Good serve first up. And off the block, but Italy get the point. So couldn't control it at the net. The white spiker with the first serve for the Italian team. Poor spike from Russia. It's Italy. It's second point, and it's back with Bossetti. Rather a different start here by Russia for a team that's four wins from four matches, and Estes there, the experienced player, just reminding some of the younger players they've got to switch on and concentrate fully from the word go. Well picked up. Lots of patience here, the Russians with this set. Got to good work at the net from the Italians. And over the top, yes, big gap there on the front court and exploited by the Russians. Venture over now to serve. Bit of a free hit here for the Russians. But, well picked up there by Decorda. Got to get it back over the net, and they do so. Now what can the Russians do? And the Italians, you're never out until you're out in these sets. Del Core. And the Russian coach can't believe that they lost that rally. And nice high set. And off the Russian block and out. I think it may have fallen on the Russian side of the net from the block. It couldn't get it over the net. And so the Russian coach decides to talk with players. Sergei Ovchinnikov calling the timeout. good start here by Italy. They now have a chance to control this first set with this 5-1 lead. Russians just looking a little flat at the moment. And no real problems at all for the Italians picking up these blocks and replying with interest with a very fine spike indeed. And playing with a lot of confidence, Italy, as a result of these fairly easy points they're picking up here at the start of this match. Klejcova not able to get that. Oh, well saved, but it goes out. A dive there from the libero, Di Gennaro. Karapikina here serving for Russia. Too big and out. Karapikina continue to serve. Has Russia won that rally? The libero for Italy moved across and took it well. And set in the spike. Service back with Italy. It's 7-3. Too big and out. Tall figure there of Ekaterina Gamova. 2 meters and 2, 6 feet 8. 8 points and first a technical timeout. So back with Gioli to 8-3. Handy lead that the Italians have here, but the Russians are striking early after the timeout. Spike and no great problems for the Russian defender in the backcourt. Big spike. See that unguarded space. Pretty messy here for the Russians. They get the point as it comes off the Italian block and out. Training by 9-5 and take any point regardless of which way they come. Evgenia Estes, a familiar figure to those that have followed volleyball at the Olympic Games in recent times. This is her 6th Olympics. Sharova with the spike. Through the block and away for the win. Just this again. Yes, kept alive by the Russians, but they had no choice but to just hit the ball over the net. Chance here for Italy. Again, a bit untidy here on the Russian court. And a very high hit there from Italy, giving time for the defenders to get into possession. But again, Russia, with a nice touch there, reading the play well. Just a little dink over the top. Couldn't quite get it. And, a bit wobbly there for a moment for the Russians, but nicely disguised. Didn't go up for the spike, it was good, just a little dink. And Koche, driving back.
Attiriamo lungo e cambio palla. Poi non possiamo regalare rete. Abbiamo detto palla alta, anticipiamo un ordinato. Palla alta, abbiamo detto con l'aereo di 5 va dietro. Oh, abbiamo fatto il video, eh? Vai!
So far in this first set from both teams. The set is just trying to dip the ball, tip the ball over the blockers. Paying the dividend for it today. Good block there again from Koshka Bande. Blocking is leaving the earth at the right time. The Italian block, but kept alive by the libero. Now here comes the spike. Too big. Captain of the Russian side is Maria Porosenko, little blocker, meter 90. A nice wobbly float serve there, always hard to pick up, but Germans did well. Lucia Bassetti coming in for the kill. Good swing on the ball. Service goes to Valentina Araghetti. 12-10, Italy hanging on to this lead they've had from the start of the match. Before the spike was executed. Net. And goes to 13-10. So around about the halfway stage of this first set. Champions, Russia, but haven't been in great form over the last 12 months. Failed to qualify in the Continental Olympic qualifying tournament. Had to go to Japan in May for the last attempt to qualify, which they managed to do. And that's why they're here in London. 14-12. Spiker. Chardover with the serve. 14 to 12. Favour of Italy playing in the white strip. And again, one of those very deceptive dipping, floating serves. Kochi, the libero, nearest to the camera, unable to receive that cleanly. Again, they've closed the gap to 14 all. They have not been ahead at any stage in this set. Now's their chance for the first time. 14 all. Just putting a little bit of heat on the Italian defence here at the moment. And they're struggling a little with these float serves. That was better work from the Italians, but again, having to rescue this rally off the Russian block and out. Immensely popular sport amongst the women in Italy volleyball. In fact, it's considered to have more registered competitive players than any other sport as far as women are concerned in that country. Yes, good play there from the Italians. They had the crowd fully covered. They were able to receive that spike and set it up for their own attack. And we've hit 16, another technical timeout. The Grande, number 18, just through to the right there, just disappearing out of the camera shot, has been the most productive of the Italian attackers with 4 points today. There she is, the tall figure at the back in the dark hair, the ponytail. Two spikes and a couple of kill blocks. It seems that every country here has got plenty of supporters at the volleyball. A lot of European countries here, of course, which just makes it easier for their fans and supporters to get to these Olympic Games here in London. European powerhouse still in battle, unbeaten these two teams so far in London, each with 4 wins from 4 matches. Italy hanging on to this narrow lead they've had for the whole of the first set. No panic in the Italian defence again, just carefully going about their work and giving Russia a chance. But again, this well-positioned backcourt play of Italy means they're picking up a lot of these spikes, being able to turn defence into offence. That's why they've got this useful little lead. It's not a winning lead by any stretch of the imagination, 17 to 14. They are playing well, both on defense and on attack. Bundy with the serve. Here again, we see the ability to pick up these tips. And another big swing and another good rally for Italy. It's 18 to 14. Prompts a timeout from the Russian coach, Sergei Ovchinnikov. It is fascinating to watch the different reaction from the coaches. Some, like in the case there of Ovchinnikov, really just wanted to interrupt the momentum of the opposition. The Italians really didn't have anything to say at all. Other coaches use every second to impart as much information and instructions as they can. But others just like to let the players have a break and 30 seconds to unwind. Sometimes it works. Looks like it has here for the Russians. They've come back invigorated and refreshed to win the first round in 2015. Pina serving now for Russia, trying to narrow this gap down. Yes, that's one of the best blocks we've seen from the Russian front line in this match. Violi with the spike, straight to Sokolova, and really have her body in the correct position there, and have her body behind the ball. So it spins away, 19-16. Here come the Russians. It's been the most productive attack they've had on that right-hand side with the Gamova. For 5 points so far in this set, just one behind Chadova with six. The Russians are coming. Hunting down the Italians, 19-18. Well, that was a poor receipt there from the Italians, but credit to the servers, well, Gamova. And the ball just popping up over the net and sitting up there waiting for the spike. Julie dished out. Yeah, just blocked the spike. Substitution made. 19-0. The net down out. And so for the first time in the match, it's Russia with their noses in front by 20-19. That prompts a timeout from the Italian coach. And they will be especially disappointed if they lose this set after controlling it for the first 21 minutes. Only now have they surrendered the lead. Massimo Bobolini, coach of the Italian side. Yes. That's the sensing that they can now win this set. They've been on the back foot for most of it, but getting their noses in front, and even at 20-all, they know that they're for the winning. So, a bit more urgency about their work. Good work from the libero, getting in early there with the reception, and again, powerful smash coming from Gamova. She really did step up to the mark there. As he said, just the right height. Climb off the wall. Swing down and through the ball, 21-20. Well, this is pretty much how I think most people expected this match to go, point for point. The two unbeaten teams in this pool, no one's got the better of them yet. Shape picks it up, and the opposite number does the same. So tipped it up, and it's in. Point goes to Russia. Very pleased with herself. Pontina. This is there for the line judge. 22-21. Points away. There's the free ball now for the Italians. But Russia with some splendid defensive work here. Clock set as well. The libero for Italy and off the block and the point in rally won by Russia. Now 2 points clear. Timing their run perfectly at the business end of this first set here to get themselves in a position to win it after trailing it. Since the word go for the last couple of minutes. Just trying to shift the angle of that spike to try and cut it more, but in doing so, she overcooked it and went out of bounds 24-21. All of a sudden, set point here for Russia. Really haven't been in the set up until the last couple of minutes, but now they can win it, but not with a serve like that. So it's got some hope for Italy, 24-22. Getty, the little blocker, goes to the service line. And some problems here now for Italy. They've got no choice but just to give the free ball back to the Russians. And Gunovic climbed in there for the big spike, but picked up in the backcourt. Still alive. Italians doing well here. It's a great rally. First set hanging on it here for Russia. If they can win this rally. Eventually the Italians prevail. It was a roller coaster ride for both teams in that rally. Desperation. Fueling the defense there. Both teams absolutely determined to keep that ball alive and wait for the opposition to make a mistake. And Italy still got some work to do here to win this first set at 23-24, but they're in the game. Definitely they're in the game at 24-all. Valentina Arrighetti. Trying to give the advantage here to Italy. If it is easy to score points when you are receiving a serve rather than delivering it. The set from there by Russia and set up for Gunova, but nicely picked up there by Lubenko. With a high set, and this time gets through the outstretched arms of Lubenko, the Italian captain, and the point goes to Russia. What a Lubenko. Hesitation there, and before she was able to get her arm to the ball, it had hit the floor. So now set point. What's this? The fourth for the Russians, trying to close out this first set. Not yet. This is Italia, 25-all. Chance here for Russia to take this first set of 26-25. We've been in business for 28 minutes. Lubenko. That's their setter. And she is setting it up for the spike. And off the block, get out. 26-all. You can't leading the serve into the backcourt. That's the call. It's out. And Russell's opinion suggesting that they felt it came off the block and out. The way the referee saw it, 27-26. Chance for Italy then now. Yes, and they have. Confusion at the net there from the Russian blockers has given the rally and the set to Italy. So a really roller coaster ride there for the Italians. They controlled and led the game and the set for the first 20 points, then surrendered the lead to the Russians, conceded four set points to Russia, who were unable to convert any of them, and then a little surge at the end carries Italy ahead of Russia. 28-26, 29 minutes it took for Italy to strike the first blow here in this clash of the heavyweights in Pool A. Another spiking by the Russians, but only 16 successful ones. Slightly better rate there for the Italians. Three aces from Russia, and a couple of service errors there as well, and none for Italy. Good serving from the Italian team. As the captain, Molinaro, with the anchor, striving for the ball. So I think they would have been very disappointed if they had conceded that first set, considering that they led after the first 20 points. Washington has scored up to 21-20 to Russia. They took the lead for the first time. Held on to it for an extra two or three points. Couldn't close it out to within the 25. And not surprisingly, a very big crowd. Full house here to see this match between these two unbeaten teams. It's part of 15,000 people here at Earls Court, Southwest London, the exhibition hall. Very intimidating the feeling to be down there on the courts, whether the stadium is empty or full. And as we progress through the knockout rounds, there will be an enormous amount of noise coming from this big crowd as well, probably making as much noise as if there was a rock concert here, of which there have been many famous ones down through the years. For the Italians in that first set, the middle blocker, and 4 points coming from Costa Grande, and also from one of the Borsetti sisters. So the workload and attack being evenly spread on the Italian team. And the Russian team. Child and far and away, well, she's got 26 points, and done a lot of tall, experienced player climbing in with 7 and far and away. Most prolific scorers for Russia, 16 of their 26 points coming from those two. Italy to serve at the start of the second set. First set there for Jarova with six successful spikes. And can the libero get to it? Yes, you're allowed to use your boot in that instance there. And it didn't quite do it. We have seen one or two spectacular saves from the defenders using their foot in the volleyball, where they go back and do the almost like what you would say in football is the bicycle kick for the goal, kicking the ball back over their head as they slide towards the ground, but keeping the ball in play. But the Italian libero there, Paula Kretzer, unable to do that. Russia to a 2-2 love lead. Italy looking for their first point. Three times the Italians tried to smash their way through the Russian block, and eventually it succeeded. Reaction by those Italian backcourt players. From the Italian spikers, and they're into the set 4-3. Dioli again, most terrific score in the first set. Quickly on the scoreboard in this early part of the second set. Block, straight onto the floor to Russia. Looking for that gap between the front court and the back court, and she found it. Depowered the swing, and the ball traveling slowly across the net. She's still in front. Better start here by the Russians. There's the Gioli, their most lethal attacking weapon so far in the match. Free ball, and yes, they do get the point, a bit fortuitous, the ball just clearing the white paint from the Russian block. Keep it right there by the Russians, but to no avail in the end. So, 5-5, good fight back here from Italy, down 4-1 a few moments ago. Formidable sight when she comes up through the middle there, Ekaterina Gumova, now 31 years of age, 2 meters and 2 centimeters. Formidable sight as she rises off the court near the net for the spike. Contact with the net there, so the point goes to Russia, 7-5, even though Italians thought initially they had won the rally. So no issues there, 7-6. It's the Italian captain, Eleonora Lobienko, their setup. Good serve, just picked up by the libero. But no real drive in that Russian attack after that good serve. Easy block there for Gioli. Goes to Russia and a timeout.
Шага еще поуже, потому что мы не цепляем, без касания проходит. Надо хотя бы там нам что-то выцепить. Потому что они нас этим убивают. И я вас прошу, когда из глубины мячи высокие, готовьте, чтобы не упал у нас накат. Падают накаты. Давайте, пошли.
Давай.
Almost a deathly hush descends over the stadium as we await the resumption of this second set, with Russia trailing by 1-0, but up by 8-7 in the second set. Paola Cocci to resume the set, and good work there from the Italians. Finished off with nice swing there from Lucia Bossetti, their spiker, and no way at all that Russia could receive that cleanly. Oh, it's far too big. She got the timing all wrong with that serve. Save from the back court, but some blocker going up there very quickly, flicking the ball instantly over the net, winning the rally for her side. 10-8, Russia to serve. Time that block and the jump. Just to know instinctively when both of you, the exact moment you've got to leave the floor, you don't get the timing right with the jump, and it's usually a fairly easy point for the opposition. Ligeti. Yep, says the main judge, it was out. So far in the match, so she's had a good day so far. Touch the net, I think that Italian set her. Explosive in the two teams for attack.
Prendiamola questo, questo è facile, ok? Sul contrattacco ogni tanto, quando è facile, è avanti in quattro. Chiamiamo voi attaccanti di qua, chiamiamo una nove. Perché sul contrattacco stanno tutti larghi, ok? Ci aspettano. Ogni tanto, una palla, una nove, entriamo. Ok?
Vai, via.
Thank you.
extending their lead to 4 points now, Russia. This is significant break in the second set here. Russia desperate to get back into this match and get a set on the board. They're just narrowly losing the first. Cleared the net, so play on. That's how to block the spike. Trying to jump to perfection and also had the angle of the hand pointing towards the floor, which is the only direction the ball could go. See there as the hand came forward and dipped and into the floor it went. There's the dummy spike, but the Italians were ready for it. Croce, the libero, gets in there, does good work at the net. Substitution made. 16. Lulia Mikhailova comes into the match for the first time in that front line for Russia. Russia does well. The two-person block. The job done for Russia to win that rally and extend their lead. 16-10.
Il lavoro ce li fanno se sbagliamo noi in ricezione che non possiamo dire non sbagliamo più. Però la teniamo alta e dopo facciamo giocare loro. Il contrattacco se non abbiamo freddo, stiamo urando bene. Sulla seconda linea aspettiamo un pelino di più, ok? Aspettiamo un pelino di più e ci stiamo chiudendo bene. Vai, via!
Plenty of encouragement coming from the bench there to the Italian on-court players as they prepare to resume this second set. 6 points behind. That's a significant deficit they're conceding here. Six feet two, one of the smaller statured players on the Russian side. The only go-to player, and she's had a very productive day, being, as I said, the top point scorer. It's 11 so far. It hit the floor first before it was picked up by the Italian defender. 17-11. This very useful cushion the Russians in the second set. Tenth successful spike today for Simona Chioli. She's at the service line as well. New player on the court gets her first point of the match, Lulia Mikhailova, 2 meters and two, using all of that height as well. First move, I suspect, by the Italians, and I'm pleased that it paid off. Porte getting the tip. Small delay here while a substitution is made in the Italian team. get to that. Spinning off the forearms of the Italian libero, Paolo Croce, and out 18-19-13. By that official to stop that Italian brass getting into that dangerous looking chair that had been upended. Up from the Russian block, so Italy pull back one, but still 5 points down. In the first to 25, of course, wins the set. It's been by two clear points. Ricordo. Getty again to serve. Really fighting to stay alive in this second set. Trailed for most of it. And Russia with the little tip, it didn't work. High set, little tip again, but interference at the net. And that's 1 point closer for Russia, 21-15. That's his look there on the face of Katerina Bozzetti. How Italy can get back into the set, well, it's very difficult because Russia very much on their game at the moment, playing a lot better here than they did in the first set. And 22-15, looked as if they've got a hand firmly on the second set. Trying to go over the top of the block, but it didn't work. Point to the Italians. The player on the court for the Italians. In the closing stages of this second set. Good serve. Dipping, swirling, and off the forearm and out over the backcourt. Mattia Bozzetti. Slightly anxious moment here for Ovchinnikov, the Russian coach. And that's big. So that's in, yes, point to Italy, 22-18. Excellent work by Croce. Splitting the Russian defense. Timeout.
Давайте пошли.
Minutes we've had so far on the match. 22-18. Russia leading Italy in the second set. And this match has pretty much followed the predictions for most of it, it would be a tough, hard, dur battle, point by point. No one really getting away from each other, and that's proved to be largely the case. Opportunity here for Russia to take this rally, and that's what they do after that free hit. Niko Mikhailovic, the spike, 23-18. Again with the serve. Quick strike with the block there from Russia, but picked up by the Italians and out off the Russian block, 23-19. Italy still with that chance here. Just the band they're serving. This time the Russians get to set point. 24-19. Tall, powerful figure of Gamova. And it should be easy for Russia to finish off. Just a simple return over the net, set up there and swung away for the 25th point, which gets Russia back on equal terms with Italy, one set all, 28-26 and 19-25. The scoreline so far in the match, we've had 52 minutes of volleyball, and it's all tied up. Best of five, of course, if it does go to a fifth set, it will be the shortened set, first to 15. And plenty at stake in this match as we look at the tail of the tape, as it were, or the stats from that second set. Good solid performance from the Russian attackers with their spikes, too many blocks, and not too many digs from the Russians either. Yeah, so these two teams in Pool A, both with similar records, 4 wins, 12 points, and therefore the team that wins this match will take out Pool A, and they will get the benefit then of playing the team that finishes fourth. One plays four in two of the quarterfinal matches, and then the other two positions, two and three, the names literally go into a hat and a draw is done. It's done so that no one can kind of manipulate the draw to make sure they play a certain team in the playoffs. And the incentive to win the pool is that in theory get an easier opponent in the quarterfinal, because you'll play the team that finishes fourth, and certainly whoever does finish fourth in the other pool won't particularly, I imagine, look forward to playing the winner of this match, because whoever it is will also have still an unbeaten record. Both these teams unbeaten so far, but one of them clearly is going to lose today, but the other will go into the quarterfinals with a 5 wins from 5 matches record. There's the attempt by Croce to try and kick the ball back into court, but to no avail. This could be a very decisive set in the context of this match here. Both teams have struck in the first two sets. They've won a set each. So this third set becomes all important. Sergei wants a little fluid top up here in this warm atmosphere. With this Doubles Court Exhibition Centre. And Russia to serve to start the third set. Decore getting the ball back. Not too easy for Russia. Setting it up the attack here, and it's in. Sokolova, number five. Lubov. Sokolova. It's the first point of the third set. Fly by the Italians. Rossetti. 9 from 16, so she's had a good day, the Italian attacker. Times today, it's a 11th successful spike and 13 points overall for Simona Ghioli. Over the top of the net and under the floor, Russia win the rally, take the point. Felipe Balkina again. The service line. So has to just put that on the inside of the paint, and the Italians draw level with Russia early in this third set. One set all, three all. Gonchareva, as the ball came back, didn't need to set it up. She just saw the gap there and just swung the ball and her arm through it. Serving's been pretty good in this match so far, just three faulty serves from each side. Nicely in this set here, Italy got the attack working, and that, yes, prompts a timeout from the Russian coach to try and disrupt this flow here from Italy. The attack working nicely early in this third set. There we go, with the Italian captain Lobianco with the serve. Well picked up by Croce. There's this set from the spike, and the Italian block gets to it, but can't get it back over the net. Falls on their side. They're up by three. Set, or most of the second set came on late in that second set. 202, she's got plenty of height, being used to good effect here. She's made her impression felt very early in the match, early in her appearance, with three successful spikes from four attempts so far. Yes, a lot of area there, but good work by Kletchikova. She managed to pick the ball up. Remarkable the skills that these liberos bring to the game. You see them dive like that there, and you would think for all money the ball has hit the ground, but they can slide their fingers underneath the ball and get it off the ground. But in the end, the Italians won the rally anyway, but some excellent work mid-rally there from Kletchikova, the Russian. Liberos must wear different coloured strips so they're easily identifiable, because they can't venture into the front court, in front of that white line, the 3 metre line. They must stay behind that line. They're effectively a backcourt player, so whenever the rotation requires them to go to the front court, they are replaced. They're purely defensive players, and their function is to try and receive the serve. It's possible, because obviously the server from the other side never trying to position the ball away from the libero, because they know they are very good receivers. Antonella Del Corre. Yeah, you see the Russian libero positioning herself to receive that serve, but a bit of confusion there on the Russian defense, couldn't get it over the net, and Talits lead the lead to 4 points. Russians to dictate that second set, and the Russia went on to win by 25-19, but Italy a lot more aggressive, fluent in this third set. Number six, this lead they have, long way to go though, not yet strictly speaking at the halfway stage of this set. To convince the Italian blockers that she was setting for the spike, and then just caught them unawares with the little tip. They really do have to be thinking all the time, the setters, very aware of what's happening across the other side of the net, where players are, where they're moving to, where they've come from. Thank you. too big. Yes, I think as it just bounced over the white line, the service line. Timeout, 14-7. This is now a very useful lead that the Italians have built in this third set. One set all. Playing for the top position in pool A. Russia finding it hard to get into the set. And there's one of their few successful spikes so far, 14-8. Just to galvanize the Russian side to their game. A little more urgency to their play because they're being outplayed here quite clearly by the Italians in this third set. There's a bit of a free hit here for the Italians, and they didn't execute that as well as they could have, but they were aided by some sloppy work at the net from the Russians, and Italy up by 15-8. Costa Grande. Russian defenders there to receive that. But, no way they could pick that powerful spike up coming from Antonella Del Porta. He's been one of the top spikers here at the Olympic Games. 39 to her credit before this match. And she was
the eighth most
prolific scorer in the tournament, largely because of his spikes, 39 spikes in four previous matches. That was a very handy one, appreciated, I'm sure, by her coach, Massimo Babalini. Venture out of their own free area, as they call it. So the players can get back into formation. And doing well here at Italy. Russia come at them again, and that's off the arm of an Italian defender and out, and so Russia get the point. And that's exactly why you need a libero on the court most of the time, that shorter stature, lower center of gravity enables them to get down low and fast across the floor that the bigger players simply cannot do. wasn't much that Croce could do with that one, as it was stinging past her at a rate of knots. Left alone, good call by Lucia Bassetti. 17-11, set to the edge ever closer to this probably quite pivotal third set here. One set apiece, certainly going to go to at least four sets. That's it, but easily picked up there by Arachetti. Bassetti comes in with a big smash, but some block equal to the occasion. Gunnover again, this time nicely disguised, putting the spike away, going for the little tip, but apply there from Italy, but picked up nicely again by the backcourt libero. Here comes another spike from Gunnover, that's two they've repelled. So they try a different tactic here. The Croce, the Italians, doing a sterling job here, and they prevail. The personification of patience, the Italians in that rally there. They do work hard on their defensive game, and led by some inspirational reception there from Croce, who kept the rally alive, and eventually the Russians ran out of court. 18-13. The Russians will strike back quick from Mikhailova. 18-14. Fighting hard here as well. Johnny spike, but the Russian defense ready for it, but couldn't do much about that from Violi. Successful spikes so far for Simona Ghioli. We go to Russia. 15-15. Yes, you see the look on Coach Barbaloni's face. He knows that the third set is not far away, but the Russians may be a little too close for comfort here, starting to close in on his charges. Need a nice set here. And good block there from Russia, however. And they're doing some excellent work here, the Russian defenders, and it pays off, that good defensive work, eventually setting up the spike. 19-16. Chartova put it away. 19-16, 1 hour and 11 minutes. So this match has been in progress, getting towards the end of the third set.
Facciamo quel lavoro, saltiamole di fronte, ok? Anche se c'è l'utile, saltiamo di fronte, prendiamo linea. Il 6 resta in mezzo, l'1 va a prendere il pallonetto, d'accordo? Vai!
Still very much on a knife here this match, as we expected. No quarter given or no quarter asked here from either of these sides. It's a war of attrition, point by single point. At this late stage in the set, every point starts to assume almost the significance of the gold nugget to 1917. Just over the net, and so a chance here for the Russians again, but not a particularly accurate spike here. Just a lack of concentration or something, but it just sailed out of court. So important point there for Italy. Substitution made in the Italian ranks. But easily picked up in the backcourt. Two quick points from Italy. That's what they needed. They'd stalled there for a while as the Russians started closing in. The number 21-17. They've got a little bit of breathing room here now. Italy, a chance now to take out this third set. Take a 2-1 lead. But they're not home yet in this set. Here comes the big spike. She's had an outstanding game there. Libero, and yes, inside the white paint. That's another valuable point from the bank there for Italy, 22-17. Just a grande. Eighth successful spike of the match. Deep serve. And Italy very deliberate here, just taking their time, just making sure that they keep the ball alive. Over the net it goes. And I thought that was a very ambitious play there. Going for the cut spike. And it didn't hit the angle right. So the Russians within four. Not much to play with here at 18-22. It'll be off Shostakova, their spiker, meter 92. Puts the float serve down. Nice block at the net. 22-19. Fresh builder doing the work there. Serve again. Spike coming up. What's the call? And it's in. Top of the net for the ball, and Ross are under a bit of pressure here. Nice crotch again. And there it is, nicely set up, but well picked up again by Kletchikova for Russia, and coming in with the big spike. Handsome shot. 23-20. Showing out a court off the Russian block. Violi. Top scorer today with 17 points so far. Yes, nice work there from that was coming out of it. That's number 8. Top scorer in the match actually with 22 by far. 16 spikes, very effective with her attacking play today, Gonchardova. Italy trying to close out this set here. I'm not sure what happened there. Might have been just a misunderstanding between those two players in the backcourt for Italy. And so that's a popular timeout. The coach just needs to calm his players down, just get them to focus on the job.
La difesa entra, se la palla va lunga, tanto la giochiamo in qualche modo. Ma se il muro si toglie, quel passo avanti lo dobbiamo fare, lo sappiamo. Ok? Vai, via, questa palla.
Important third set secured by Italy, 25-22. In the 25 minutes, they lead by 2-1 in this clash of the two top teams, the two unbeaten teams in Pool A, Italy and Russia. Just at the moment, the advantage lies with Italy, up by 2-1. Side able to secure 50% ratio with their spikes. Italy 14 successes from 39. Successful blocking at the net there from the Italians, 5 from 16. Russia successful with more digs, 21 out of 30. You can see an ace from either side in that set, but to three service errors there from the Russians. Russian team stand out, Goncharova and Gumova, between them 40 of their 73 points, 23 to Goncharova and 17 to Gumova, and 31 successful spikes between them. So that's where Russia profit, is when they can get those two into the sets and get them swinging their big long arms at the Italian blockers. That's where their points are coming from, but far more even spread amongst the Italian team. Bossetti and Violi with 15 and 17 points respectively, and Costa Grande with 10. So they do have attacking strength right through their squad, the Italians. And so perhaps reliant quite so much on rotation or substitution. Interesting to see here now how the Russians respond to having dropped that third set. They know their backs are somewhat against the wall here. They've got to win this set to stay in the match. Of course, neither side is absolutely desperately having to win this match, because they've both qualified for the last eight for the quarterfinals in a couple of days. But as I mentioned before, the prize here for the team that does win this match, and with it wins Pool A, they will get to the easier draw in the quarterfinals. They will play the fourth placed team in Pool B, whereas the team that loses this match, so their name literally goes into a hat into a draw amongst the teams that are second and third in the other pool. So they could be playing the team that finishes second in pool B, or they could be playing the team that finishes third in the other pool. Or in the drawing of the name out of the hat. Russia with a good start here. Shashkova with the serve. Four players in the backcourt there, and that left most of that, the front court vacant, and exploited there by Russia. 3-0. Well, Russia seem, if the pattern of this match is to continue here, to play their best of volleyball when they are coming from behind. Got the first set, and were much a better team in the second set, and look at this. They've jumped out to a 4-love lead here. The start of this fourth set, that prompts the timeout.
Giocare ai 300 all'ora prima, adesso caliamo subito. Spostiamo le gambe, ripeto sempre la stessa cosa, tanto la scelta è qui, La scelta è qui, questa zona, ok? 5-6, si batte sul ricettore. Va bene? Vai, andiamo.
Vai, raga! Andiamo! Andiamo!
Of it at the moment, the Russians, this is probably just about the biggest lead we've seen between the two teams at any stage of this match. Russia up by 5-0, looking to extend it to 6, and no, out is the call. Well, is it? No, it's in there. Looked into the naked eye here, but the first referee was indicating that it was out, but we'll have another look at it. That's the paint. That's good. 6-0. Completely different feel about this Russian team in this fourth set. Quite remarkable, exactly what we saw from them in the second set after they dropped the first. They come out a different team. 7-0 right at this moment. You would think this is going to 5 sets. Perhaps there's a little complacency in the Italian team. 8-0. You can do this, you can get on a roll like this, and the points just seem to come very easily. And we are having a technical timeout here, because
got one team Robolini
there, the coach, saying, look at the scoreboard, 8-0, what's going on here?
Adesso loro si difendono, non è che loro stanno facendo di più, siamo noi, Siamo noi che abbiamo calato, va bene? Vai, via!
If they don't turn this set around very quickly, they'll inevitably drop the mindset that, we've lost this set, let's focus on the fifth set. But so Russia here, I'm sure, keen to push on, not allow any quarter here to the Italians, to let them get back into this set, because if they win it, the Italians, they win the match. Here with Russia with a stranglehold on this fourth set. And finally, by the look of it, the Italians are on the board. Their first point at 8-1. The point system here, volleyball at the end of the game, so if you win by 3-0 or 3-1, you get 3 points. But if you are taken to 5 sets before winning the match, 3-2, you only get 2 points, and the other point goes to the team that loses for taking the match to 5 sets. But those permutations won't be relevant here, because this is the last match. Whoever wins the match will win this pool. So that's all that matters here, whether it's the 3 sets, 4 sets, or 5 sets. And again, Italy slow to react. Those four backcourt players, no one covering the front court. Libero reacted a little too slowly, maybe didn't get there in time. 10-1. It's almost embarrassing here for Italy, that up by 2-1, and they've been taken apart here in the fourth set. But that can be urgent upon the faces of the players, particularly Simone Ghioli. Urging the players to lift their game. Meanwhile, chasing down everything, and their attack working very sweetly now. 11-2, Italy with no answers. Fourteen successful spikes for Gumovic tonight. That's better from Del Corre. White spiker, and plenty of room there to swing and free her arm, and 11-3, Ghioli. Off the Italian block, but kept alive, going for the tip, and get to it, Russians, Italy, 11-4, still a long way behind. And back there, the Italians, well disguised, left the floor, conveying the message that she was preparing for the spike, and then just dinked it into the vacant court. 12-5. That's what a float serve can do to you as well. It can just die right in front of you. Can make you look a little bit embarrassing, but it's more the aerodynamics of the ball once that panel is flattened from the palm, from the hip, from the palm of the hand. How many times have we seen that from Gumovic tonight? Set up the middle, she leaves the backcourt and just hammers it. Seven. Still looks a little better than it did at 9-1, but Russia still with, I would think, not necessarily a stranglehold in the box seat to take this set and send the match to five. There's their 14th point. Player, and Italy Struggling to keep this alive. Off the block and out. And all happening for Russia here. Everything going their way. A little bit of luck, I guess, in any sporting event. 15-7. Russia, who had that golden era back in the 1990s. And then, I suppose, in the ultimate time, it was the Soviet Union. And with the four successive Olympics, they went fourth, second, fifth. And something similar back in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. Four times winner of the Olympic gold medal. And Italy never won a medal at the Olympic Games. And the dummy spike working beautifully for Russia. The first wave going up, pulling in the defense, and then the second wave coming in with the real spike. And it's a technical timeout. It's 16-8. Been in progress for 12 minutes in the fourth set. Calm and moderate presence on the bench tonight, the Russian coach Sergei Ovchinnikov, but now with his team very much in control, a bit more urgency about his words to his players. Just making sure, I guess, that they don't lose concentration here and make sure that they close out this fourth set. Replacement before they get back onto the court, some of those Russian players. Good arena, Gamova coming off for replacement. Substitution coming on as Lubov Shaskova about to resume the match with Russia very much in control of this fourth set at 16-8. Off the block. Still there for Italy. And nice work by Kukchukova, the libero for the Russians. And they go again. Just one attack after the other here from the Russians. Remorseless. And the Italians unable to repel it. 17-8. That's the other good thing here for Russia. If they do take out the set comfortably, they'll have the momentum with them going into that shortened fifth set. First to 15. Good drive there again by Croce, the libero for Italy, but to no avail in the end. 18-8, 10-point advantage. Shouldn't lose this set from here. Shaskova. Just clearing the top of the net. The forearms underneath it, but the body directly behind the board, and so it spins away on that angle. And can't be retrieved. Can you imagine already the thoughts in these minds of these Italian players as the fifth set? Desperation about making the hits in that set there, that rally. In the end, too big, 19-9. Nice work there from Cimini. Not too much of her in the game. Yeah. That's the open side spike from Gumover again, and they're successful. Playing a 236th match for Russia, over the top. Good, smart thinking from the setup. Gumover again, that's their go-to play when they need a point just to settle things down. They run that little set there where they just put it up right in the middle of the court, and from the back court to Gumover, launches a tall frame in and over the ball. 21-12. Well, it was in by the look of it, no. Just get a naked idea. It looked as if it hit the paint, but anyway, the lines are short. He's right there. Taking this match to a fifth set. Timeout call, but I think the writing is on the wall here for the Italians. Important thing here, I imagine, for the coach of Bavolini is to make sure these players, these Italian players, are up and right frame of mind for this fifth set, because take a bit of a hammering here from the Russians. And they've completely shut Italy out of this fourth set, which could have gone the Italians' way. That would have been the match. But Italy has not had a look at here. The Russians have reached the best form of the match here in this set. Here with the serve to get back into the set. Let's see if Goncora can achieve it. Goes Milikova. Kept alive by the Italians. They are fighting tooth and nail. And there they go again. It works every time. Gumover. Attack they've got. They set it up for her. She lands in the front court, which she has to do. Leaves from the back court. Bit untidy, but kept alive there by the Italians. And off the Russian block, and out 23-15. Nervous as well, but he's got 8 points up, or his team have got 8 points to play with here. They should not lose this set from here. 15-23, to the end of the serve. And a wide attack, but easily repelled by the Italians. And there it is, set point now, 24-15. To tie it up at two sets all. And it's in, 24-16, over yet. So now the difficult part here for Italy. Trying to keep the Russians out here. Fair serve. Needs a good serve in the first instance. Nicely set up, and there it is. To 16, just 21 minutes. Next to no time at all for the Russians to take out their fourth set and to tie this match up at two sets all. So it's into a fifth set we go. First to 15, remember. And momentum clearly with the Russians after that very emphatic fourth set victory, 24-25-16. And a very clear pattern there, as you can see just from the green colours, that each set has been followed by the next set being won by the opposition team. So Italy won the first and the third. Russians the second and the fourth. Very good strike rate from the Russian attack there. 20 out of 30 successful spikes. Italy not doing too badly either. 12 out of 28, but less than 50%. No success with the bricks or blocks. And it was all Russia, really. They controlled that match right from the word go. We're leading 7-0 at one stage, 9-1. Before Italy really got into the set at all, but could never bridge that gap. So ready for a start in this deciding fifth set here between Italy, nearest the camera in the white strip, and across the far side of the net, Russia, two sets all. Italy winning the first and third sets, Russia taking the second and the fourth, taking that fourth set in just 21 minutes by 25-16. And so they will have a little momentum going here, a little perhaps a mental advantage over the Italians, because they were so dominant in that fourth set. This attack in particular just took the Italians apart. They had no answer at all. And now first to 15. Good start is very important here in this short set. You get off to a 4-5-0 or 4-5-1 lead, you can control the set. So just a few rallies here, very important. Antonella Del Corte starting this fifth set. A lot at stake here for these two teams. And nice dig there. Now here comes the set, but the block, but it's out. Off the Russian block there. First point to Italy. These two teams unbeaten in the pool play, so whoever wins this match, if it's the last pool match, will win the pool. And then for that, they get the benefit of playing the fourth-ranked team in pool B in their quarterfinal in a couple of days' time. And all. Shikova with the spike. Sokolova now goes to the service line. So it's Shikova who's just won the rally with that spike. Here come the Italians, looking a little more urgent here for the Italians. They just might have just got a bit of complacency going into that fourth set and quickly exploited by the Russians, but they look to be back on the job here. 2-1. Madaghetti, six spikes from 16. Good day's work for her so far. And the dummy spike, but waiting for it was the Italian defense. Keeping the ball alive. And another successful block by the Russians. Now the set. Here comes the spike. Good work though at the net there from, first of all, number 17, Simona Ghioli, the top scorer today. He's had a outstanding game. 20 points, top scorer in the Italian team. And that's, I imagine, her 21st point. 3-1, Italy with a small advantage here. 1st-15, wins the match. No real power. Fortunate maybe because it goes out of court from the spike and the point two at the 2-3. Got a Palinka. A very solid day all round for Russia. Oh yes, lovely spike, superb angle there from Costa Grande. Her 10th successful spike today. Just threading its way through the Russian court. 4-2. Gia Bassetti, one of their leading attackers today with 14 successful spikes, 14 points. There's the set. Kubik. Telling his players by the look of his body language just to calm down, keep control of the adrenaline. There must have been plenty behind that shot as it sailed out of court. Now back to the present. Kept alive superbly there by the Italians. And back come the Russians again, and this time, yes. Looked as if for a moment there the Italians at last had been able to foil that centre court spike from Gamova, but first of all that desperate attempt to keep it on. This is the play that often has worked a treat for Russia today. Gamova coming from the back court, but that time the block was effective, except it went out for all. And a good block from Russia. Was Jenny Barazza. Haven't seen much of her in the match. She's just come onto the field here, onto the court. Here comes Gamova. Going for the little tip, but easily picked up there by Mikhailova. It's point for point here, 5-all. Must win by 2 clear points, even though it is only 1st-15. Still the 2-point advantage rule applies. Set which Russia controlled from the word go and won easily. It really has been just a war of attrition between these two teams, point for point, for now 1 hour and 45 minutes. Nice set. And over the net with the free ball and set up for Gamova again, and she applies. The top scorer at the last Olympic Games. And the 26 points today, not the top point scorer today. Parker Machado has 31 and that's caught out. A little advantage here to Russia at 8-5 for a timeout. Corte, it's a bit too big. The players will swap ends for the second half of this fifth and final set. Jenny Barazza. boxer. Haven't seen much of her in the match, but she's an experienced player, been to the last Olympics and a couple of World Championships as well. There's a serve. And good block at the net by the Russians. Going for the tip, but Merkel over there for the Russians. Looking a bit anxious as the hands start to shake. Oops, a daisy to the Italian players running into each other, but they extricated themselves from that potential little mess. And both teams here desperate to keep this ball alive, but in the end, the Italian block prevails. And they win an important point to narrow the gap to 2 points. Up goes Merkelova, but Antonello Del Corte, known for spiking, doing some pretty good defensive work there. Simone Dior, 16 spikes today for Italy, their second most prolific scorer is Gamova. You can just about put the point on the scoreboard when you see her leave the backcourt. She's got it down to a tee. Prompts a timeout, 9-6. Russia with the clear advantage here, 6 points away from winning the match.
In contrattacco alla decima palla, quella che ha murato prima. Per cui rischiamo, se giocano una pipe, una squadra, una pass, pazienza. Però andiamo a aiutare un pochino sulla pipe.
The best record at the Olympic Games of any team in the history of volleyball. Four times they've won the gold medal as the Soviet Union, 1964, 68, 1980 and 1988. And in the intervening years, between 1964 and 1992, when they didn't win the gold medal, they finished second. So they just had an extraordinary Olympic record there for 28 years. Since the abolition of the Soviet Union, they haven't been the same force, but they are the current world champions. They won that title in 2010 and prior to that in 2006. But could only manage fifth at the Olympic Games in Beijing in 2008, their worst ever performance at the Olympic Games. So here, with a small advantage over the Italians and a chance to take out Pool A. And I feel a little easier for themselves, maybe, in the quarterfinals. But the Italians, I'm sure, not done with yet. Exactly, 9-7. Del Corte again working well out there on that left hand side. Gamova, full frame over 2 meters, takes a while to get down to the floor and couldn't get down there in time. The Italian setter Rondon with the serve, and they won't get that one. Too much power. 10-7. 5 points away. The Italians playing better in this fifth set than they were in the fourth, but still you get the impression here that the Russians are controlling this set, but starting to tighten up here, 10-8. Need to get a little momentum into their attack, Italy here. Del Corte. Goes Gamova again, and this giant of a woman, 2 meters and two, 6 feet. What is 2 meters and two? 6 feet eight. And when she gets the timing right, the power, the speed, and the angle, usually too good for any defender. 11-8. Still there for Russia. Has to get it across on the third hit, and it came off the block, and a little bonus point there for Russia as it just dropped harmlessly onto the back court for Italy, and couldn't get to it. Valuable point here to Russia, closing in on this fifth set.
Non fermiamoci ragazzi, aspettiamo. Quella di prima luce era troppo di là, eh. Ricordiamo al di là della Gamova che non c'è più, che viene a Conciarova, o là. Ok, quella palla lì, se è corta entriamo un po' di più, così chiudiamo in mezzo. Dai, via!
Enormously popular sport in Italy, volleyball. Registered volleyball players than any other female sport in Italy, so this will be commanding a big audience, I'm sure. Across Italy, watching their team. who are guaranteed a place anyway. Both teams are guaranteed a place in the last eight. It's just a matter whether you finish first or second. And big difference between first and second in terms of the draw for the quarterfinals. Anyway, back to the present, to the Italians trying to close that four-point gap. They need points quickly here. Yes, and they've done it, getting it through the block and into the back court. 12-9. Costa Grande had a good game today. It's an 11th successful spike from the 4.5 sets we've had. Nearly five now, isn't it? 12-9, just 3 points away. Russia, if they can, they're only 2 points away, if they can get the next 2 points in the bag, they will win this match. 13-9. We've come back here. Remember, they were down 2-1 after they lost the first and the third set, but really just turned their game around in the fourth set, and they've carried that strong attacking game here into this fifth set. Picked up there by Nikolova. There might have been a hand on the net there from one of those Russian front court players. A little point to Italy. I think for everything they've got here. Russia by three. Italy with the serve. Ronquillo set there, and that plays into the hands of the Italians, closing in on the Russians. And sometimes it is easy to come from behind in these tight situations when all you know you need is a couple of points to win the match, and start to lose a little bit of the mental edge as you start to think about it, worry about it, perhaps change the way you play. You want to protect the lead that you have, whereas the Italians here know that they've got to go all out attack. Not going to win defensively when you're behind so close to the finish line. Some of the Russian fans don't look too optimistic, do they? Even though their side is in front here in this fifth set. Luigi Bassetti goes it. Out of it, but good block there from the Italians, but not so successful with the second wave. And here it is, match point for the Russians at 14-11. Still close to the ground, couldn't get the body and the arms properly underneath the ball. And now Gamova serving for the match. Italy desperate to keep this one alive, and there it is, into the net and onto the floor on the Italian side. And so wonderful comeback here from Russia, down by 2-1, but came back strongly in the fourth set and have taken out the fifth set 15-11 in 15 minutes, 1 hour and 55 minutes it took the Russians, and they have gone through pool play unbeaten. They top pool A and will play the fourth ranked team in pool B. Who that will be is still yet to be determined, but 5 from 5, the perfect start in the first week of the volleyball here at the London Olympic Games for the most successful team in the history of the sport. They finished fifth 4 years ago in Beijing, their worst ever showing at the Olympic Games, but clearly determined to do a lot better here in 2012. Relief and joy on the bench and amongst the Russian fans. And the Italians, they'll be disappointed, but not the end of the journey by any stretch of the imagination for the Italians. They are assured of a place in the quarterfinals, and they've finished second. So they go into this draw now to determine who they will play. It will either be the second or third team from the other pool. Names are literally put in a hat, and two names from the other pool, and that will determine who plays who. So there's the score. Italy looked to be in control there after winning the first and third sets, but a very strong finish from Russia. Emphatic winners of the fourth set and also clear winners 15-11 in that fifth set. Just a seven spikes from 21 from the Italians. The Russians going at about 50%. No aces and no service errors from either side in that shortened fifth set. And quiet descends over the exhibition centre here at Earl's Court as we look at the overall stats from the match. 64 from 159 and Russia 78 from 171. Russia with a couple of more aces. And the service errors, 6 from Russia and 4 from Italy. And all up, it took 2 hours and 8 minutes for Russia to win this match by 3-2. So just confirming how things have finished here in this Pool A, Russia get just 2 points today because they didn't win the match in three or four sets, took them five, and the third point goes to Italy for the losing, but they're losing in five sets, so it didn't really matter how many sets it took, it just mattered who won the match, and it was Russia, so they topped the pool and to play the fourth place team in Pool B, and Italy, although beaten today, finish in second place.